Hi everyone, welcome to the class. In this class, we learn, we revise the concept of real numbers. In previous classes, we have learned the natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, quotient numbers, that means rational numbers and irrational numbers. All these numbers, including in the number system. So let us revise the definition of real numbers in detail. At first, what are called natural numbers? The numbers which are used for counting are called natural numbers. The numbers which are used for counting means in our daily life we count currency, people, animals, things, so many books, pens, like that. We count by using these numbers. Without these numbers, we cannot count the articles or anything. So the set of all these numbers is denoted by English capital letter, which is the first letter of natural numbers, N. So natural numbers is equal to set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next, whole numbers. Whole numbers are represented by W. Natural numbers including zero. Natural numbers including zero are called whole numbers. Including zero. Are called whole numbers. Whole number, the first letter of whole number is W. So the set of whole numbers is represented by W. Here, the smallest natural number is 1, but we cannot decide the largest natural number. Here, because if we write any natural number, we can write one more than the natural number. So we cannot decide, we cannot write the largest natural number. If the smallest whole number is zero, and also the largest number we cannot write. Because if we write any number, there will be one more than the given number. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to infinite numbers are there. This set is called whole numbers. Next, integers. Integers. Integers means, set of integers means minus infinite 2, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Here, these are positive integers, and these are negative integers, and this is zero, neither positive nor negative. So we can define the integers as set of negative numbers comma zero and positive numbers are called integers. So here we don't know the smallest negative number. As we go from right to left, the value of the numbers is decreasing. So we don't know the smallest. We cannot decide the smallest natural number, smallest integer. But we can write largest integer or highest integer, that is minus 1. Negative integer is minus 1. Largest negative integer is minus 1. Then if we take positive integers, the smallest positive integer is 1. And we cannot decide the largest positive integer. So 0 is neither positive nor negative. Then you may have got a doubt. Why we represent these integers by z instead of I. Here the first letter is I, but we are representing z because in German the z stands for Jahlan. Jahlan means total numbers, including positive numbers, negative numbers, and zero. So Barbeque, a mathematician, named this set with Z. He represented the set by Z. From that's why this set is represented by Z from those days. So you see, these are called integers. So we use these negative integers to explain the temperature of a place. In some places in polar regions, the temperature is less than 0 degrees. So we have to represent the temperature by negative numbers. So there are so many uses from these negative numbers, by using these negative numbers. So now one more set is there, that is Q. Q means rational numbers. Rational numbers are represented by Q. Then what are called rational numbers? The numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q, where P comma Q are integers and but Q is not equal to zero. So the numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q means fractions, the form of fractions. Any number which can be written in the form of fractions, that is called rational number. The P and Q belongs to integers. You can select any value of P from this integer set. You can write example minus 3 by 7, 1 by 6, minus 2 by 8. Like this, you can select any two numbers. And then that the form of the number is called rational number. But there are two conditions to write a rational number. First, the P comma Q are integers, but Q not equal to 0. Q means your denominator should not be equal to 0. If you write a denominator like this, 2 by 0, it is not existed. Given by 0 is not defined. That's why we should not take Q is equal to 0. Except to Q is equal to 0, all numbers can be taken in the place of P and Q. Then why can't we write these set of rational numbers like this? Means we cannot write like that because there are so many rational numbers between 1 and 2 and 2 and 3. Infinite number of rational numbers between 1 and 2 and 0 and 1 and minus 1 comma 0, minus 2 comma minus 1. So we cannot write the set of rational numbers like this. So the rational numbers means which are represented by Q and the which can be written in the form of P by Q, where P comma Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. So rational numbers are two types. The first one is terminating decimals. And second one is non-terminating but repeating decimals. There are two types. Terminating decimal. For example, you can take here 1/2. 1/2 is a terminating decimal. That is equal to, if you divide 1/2, you will get 0.5. 1/4, 0.25. So 1/8, 0.125. If you divide 1/2, you get 0.5. 1/4, 0.25. 1/8, 0.125. The decimals will terminate. So these terminating decimals can be written in the form of P/Q, 1/2, 1/4, 1/8. Moreover, there are non-terminating decimals also is there. 0.3 bar means 0.333, non-terminating but repeating decimal. This non-terminating repeating decimal also can be written as a fraction or a rational number. How? This is equal to 3/9. Count here, how many numbers are being repeated here? Only one number is repeating, so write one number in the denominator, then you will get the P/Q form of this number. 3 1 ja, 3 3 ja. If you divide 1/3, you will get this 0.3 bar. Similarly, 0.25 bar, this is a non-terminating repeating decimal. That is 0.252525, like that. 252525, like that. It will continue. So we can write this one as 25/299. So we will discuss how to write these non-terminating repeating decimals into P/Q form later in other videos. So, but here I simply explain. 0.25 bar can be written as 25/99. So in this way, terminating decimals can be written in the form of P/Q, and non-terminating decimals also can be written in the form of P/Q, 1/3. Moreover, any number, a natural number, integers, any number can be written in the form of P/Q. For example, we take 3, it is a natural number, but 3 can be written as 9/3. So it is also P/Q form. Similarly, if you take 5, can be written as 10/2 or 50/10. So that's why any number can be written as P/Q form. That's why natural numbers also integers, also rational numbers. Natural numbers are also rational numbers. All natural numbers are rational numbers, but rational numbers are not natural numbers. Because rational numbers, there are fractions, there are indicative numbers, so many are there. So all natural numbers are rational numbers. All whole numbers also rational numbers. All integers. All integers also rational numbers. But all rational numbers not integers, all rational numbers not whole numbers, all rational numbers not natural numbers. So here, once again, I repeat. Here Q means quotient numbers or rational numbers. Here, rational numbers are terminating decimals and non-terminating decimals. Non-terminating but repeating decimals can be written as P/Q. terminating decimals can be written as p by q. But one more numbers are there, more type of numbers are there. They are non-terminating, non-repeating decimals. They are called irrational numbers. They are represented by q dash. Non-terminating, non-recurring or non-repeating, non-recurring decimals are called irrational numbers. Moreover, we can write this definition in one more type also. The numbers which cannot be written can't be written in the form of p by q are called irrational numbers. For example, square root of 2. Square root of 2 value is, we know that it is not a perfect square. So we can write the square root of 2 approximately, that is 1.73205081 and so on. But the this is integral part, this is decimal part. The decimal part, it is non-terminating and also the group of numbers will not be repeated, so non-recurring. Group of numbers are not repeated, non-recurring. So that's why this root 2 is called irrational number. In 9th class, we have already find the value of root 2. Then root 3 also, what is the value of root 3? It is 1 point, this is root 3 value. Sorry, this is root 3 value. And root 2, square root of 2 is equal to 1.414213 56. This is also non-terminating, non-recurring. And square root of 5 also irrational number, 2.236067 98. The decimal part, the group of numbers or any number, group of numbers or any number is not being repeated. That's why these numbers are called irrational numbers. So we cannot write the p by q form. Why? Root 2 is equal to 1.414213 56 and so on. If you try to write this number as p by q form, 1414213 56 and so on, by after one, how many zeros we have to keep here? Here I have written only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 places only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 places and so on. If you write like this, this is meaningless. So there should be an end. So we cannot keep zeros, how many zeros are there, because we don't know how many numbers are here. So we cannot write the root 2 in the p by q form, so this is meaningless. That's why the numbers, irrational numbers, cannot be written in the form of p by q. So if we review all these numbers, rational numbers and irrational numbers, if the number is rational and it cannot be irrational, if a number is irrational, it cannot be rational. So the rational numbers and irrational numbers together known as real numbers. These are called real numbers. The rational numbers and irrational numbers together known as real numbers, set of real numbers. And the set of real numbers is denoted by, real numbers are denoted by number R, letter R, capital R. So R is equal to set of rational and irrational, any number. This is about the rational and irrational numbers. So once again we review this. Here Q means here rational numbers, that is two types rational numbers terminating here, non-terminating but repeating. But repeating. The two types of decimals also called rational numbers. Q dash means non-terminating, non-repeating decimals. Non-recurring or non-repeating. Decimals. Example, square root of 2, square root of 3, square root of 5. That is equal to square root of 2 is equal to, just now I have explained, 1.414213356 and so on. So these are rational, these are irrational. Altogether, the rational and irrational together known as real numbers. Totally we known as real numbers. Okay.